Hello, everyone. I am Seetha Coleman-Kammula. I'm the president of a not-for-profit scientific organization that researches and removes toxic chemicals called PFAS from water and from the environment. I'm here to talk to you about the imposter syndrome. For those of you who may not know what that is, it is defined as a feeling of inadequacy and self-doubt that persists no matter how educated you are, how experienced and accomplished you are. I'm probably not the only one. I'd like to see a show of hands for those of you who might have felt that. It's good to see that both there are women and men who feel that way. I have to tell you that I have experienced that for a long time. I was born in a poor and very loving but extended family in India that really believes, even to this day, very, very strongly in education. My grandfather made me memorize multiplication tables of 12 at age 4. I spent most of my childhood worrying about not coming first in my class. So an underachiever under duress, an overachiever under duress, you see. Fast forward, I came to the US to do my PhD. I had to do an exam called Graduate Record Entrance Examination. I was handed a sheet of paper. I took the time, I answered all the questions, well argued, multiple choice. I gave it back to my professor, who looked at it and he said, "You didn't answer any of the questions." I nearly fainted. I was terrified. I showed him my answers and he said, "No, no, no, you have to take this pencil and circle the ones that are correct in black." I was absolutely sure that I failed. I did pretty well, but the feeling that I had failed persisted for a long time. I wonder how many people still would have remembered that. But feeling that you've failed is quite a normal, that you're not adequate, that you have self-doubt is a normal emotion. And yet, research by KPMG showed that 74% of women executives who were interviewed said that they experience imposter syndrome perhaps more than men do. There are many personal as well as organizational dynamics, power dynamics, and gender dynamics that lead you to believe that you are an imposter. In my case, I stayed away from interviewing, applying for business management jobs because in my family, business was for second-rate scientists. You either became a doctor, my daughter the doctor, my son the doctor, or you became a famous research scientist. And I found later on that this was quite common among Asian women scientists in my organization who didn't apply for business management jobs. But let's talk about the organizational dynamics. The KPMG research shows that 6 out of 10 times women feel that imposter syndrome at the time of either moving jobs or changing roles. There was a time in the petrochemical organization where I worked. It was a major reorganization. It was a merger. I was offered perhaps my best shot at breaking through the glass ceiling. The boss that I got was from a different organization. He was from a manufacturing organization that had only male engineers. I was the only female research scientist. Most of the others were male engineers. It was completely rigged against anything because his framework of perfect performance was rigged against me. One day, the human resources director came to see me and said that I should get to know him better. I just simply did not realize what I had to do I was good at the job. I knew how to do the job. I just didn't know how to play the politics. Besides, I don't golf. I don't fish. These were the normal ways of bonding in that organization. So I realized what the HR manager was telling me was that I had to fix myself. That was a long time back. Since then, don't fix the women, but fix the workplaces where women work have now become a rallying cry for many women in all races, in all places. Thank God for that. So I left. I left the corporate world. And I started, since leaving, many profit and non-profit organizations. In the process of starting these, I found my passion. My passion for a purpose, which is applying the science and the scientific understanding of many of the problems that were created by the organizations, by the companies I worked. I apply that knowledge to solve some of the more urgent problems, many of which impact women. My message to women scientists all around the world is the imposter syndrome really limits us in our careers, but more importantly, it limits us from contributing to the most important, urgent problems that the planet is facing today. The planet needs more than 50% of its people to heal. So, my message to you is find your passion, create the organizations. If you want to, you can join the organizations or create your organizations. But don't fall victim to the imposter syndrome.